Let me present to you the Descript tools. The place where you find the tools are these. When you look at the bottom here, you've got your play controls, and then you have the show timeline button here on the bottom left. Now, this will expand the timeline, and you'll see the toolbar right there on the right-hand side. These are all the tools, if you want, that Descript is using, and they are the select tool. You press A to activate this tool, the blade tool, B, the range tool, R, the slip tool is Y, because S is a split its command, so they couldn't do the S, so it's a Y, and then the hand tool. The hand tool is the least useful tool in the toolbox, because all it does, if you activate the hand tool, all it does, you can just scroll like this. That's all you do. You can't even move the playhead with it. So the hand tool is just so that you can scroll like this. You can use the hand tool if you want to click down here and kind of scrub through your timeline and make sure you're not touching something by mistake and moving it. That's all there is. Now, the next tool, which is the most important tool, is the select tool. This tool allows you to click on stuff and move it around and select and drag it and move it and resize it, whatever. So if I am in my canvas right there, I'm just going to make that larger. You can use the select tool to click on an object and move it around. You can click on another object. You can resize from the corners. You can crop objects by double clicking on them, and you can zoom and so on. That's what the select tool does. Another thing that the select tool does is, like I said, you're clicking objects and moving them, including, I'm just going to create a blank scene in here and go to the elements, and I'm going to just bring this star in here in the scene, right? So again, the select tool allows me to move objects here on the canvas and also down here. If I click on an object here, I can move it like this. You see, down in the timeline, I can move objects. If you are on any other tool, you cannot move objects. Look, so if I'm on the range tool, for example, I cannot click on this object to move it. Okay, so that's one thing. The select tool, you grab objects, you select them. And another thing, when you have the select tool, if you click on an object, whether you click on it in the canvas or down here, if you want to change any properties for that object, you have two places. One, at the top here, you've got this bar that shows up. Whenever you click on an object, whatever tools or options or properties apply to that object will show up in this bar across the top. Or you could go to layer, because any object in Descript is a layer, including the script track, which is again its own. It can have layers in it, like tracks. And this star is a layer. So if I want to change something, let's say the color, I can click on the star and choose the color from here. I'm going to make it red. Or down here, because it's already selected, go to the layer and you have the star selected, and you can click and change the color right there. I made it yellow. All of these things, like position, for example, look, I can click and drag these numbers and I'm moving the object. I can click and drag this to move it up and down, change the size, rotation. All of these things like that, you can do them when you are on this properties panel by selecting the object with the select tool. The next tool is the blade tool. The blade tool allows you to make cuts. That's all it does. You can select and click on something and it will cut it. It will split that clip right there. For example, if I have the blade tool and I want to split this star clip in two, you see, you put your mouse over it, and it has this red indicator showing where you're about to make a cut. So if I click, it has made a cut. You see, like this? If I click again, one more cut. So you can see now that my clip down there is split into three segments. Now, if I want to move these segments or do anything with them, I have to switch back to the select tool, and I can grab these little segments that I separated and put them on top of each other, move them in another scene like this. You know, you can do a lot of stuff with the select tool, like I said, but if you want to split something, you use the blade tool. And the blade tool, you will see, is very important inside of sequences, because you cannot use the range tool there the same way. Now let's move on to the range tool. I'll show you what this does. The range tool does exactly what it says. You are able to select a range or a segment in a longer clip. For example, if I go down here on the timeline and I say, I would like to delete this portion. You use the range tool and you click and drag like this. And you notice that selection I made is blue. It's highlighted with blue, meaning it's selected. So now I can do things with this. I can press delete to delete it like this. Okay, I'm gonna bring it back. Now you can also change volume. So if I want to change the volume of that selection, let's say my guest has an outburst of laughter, it's very loud or whatever. So I'm selecting that segment, going to the layer panel. Remember, the layer panel, you know, allows you to change the properties of whatever you have selected, right? So right now I have that selection and I have my layer panel and I can say, I want to mute it. If I want to mute it, click on this mute range button. And there you go. I can still see the words, but now the audio is muted. And because I have a sequence in this composition here, underneath this composition, there's a sequence with two tracks. Both of those tracks are muted now for this particular segment. Okay, I'll bring it back. You can also change volume by dragging this volume. You see the waveform going up and down. It becomes, you know, thicker or thinner, which means louder or not so loud. So here you go. That's what you can do with a range tool. The range tool, just make a selection. And also you can use the range tool at the top on particular clips. So I can make selections on the shapes, but I can make them on video and audio that exists on those layers. So for example, I'm gonna go to stock and I will bring in an audio file. Reggae is the answer. That's fine. I like reggae. Drag, you know, bring that file in here, that music file. And in a second, it's going to put it on the timeline. There you go. That is my music file. And again, with the range tool, I can basically edit just like in other editing tools. I can make a selection. Let me zoom in. I can make a selection like this with the range tool. Look at that. And it's not blue, it's green. And I can delete that. And now look, inside of that music clip, I have two little segments. I removed a part of the music. If I go to the select tool, the entire clip is still one piece because it is the music clip. But look in there, I have a cut now because the range tool, when you cut something, it closes that gap and it makes a cut right there. So that's how you use the range tool. So just to make selections. And finally, the slip tool is interesting. The slip tool, if you have used other video editing software, slipping means you have a clip. Let's say you have a video that is like 5 minutes long. The actual file is 5 minutes long, but you're only using it for 1 minute, right? So then you've got like 5 minutes of video that's not used. Well, if you want to choose the moment in that little 1 minute clip, you can shift the video inside of it like water through a hose. You can shift it left or right. Your window you're looking at, the little 1 minute clip, remains the same length, but the 5 minute clip inside of it can be shifted forward and backward. So this can be easily seen by the, you know, manipulating music. It works on music as well. So look at this. If I'm going to just make this music file shorter, you know, I'm just gonna delete all of that. So here you go. That is my music clip. It is not completely that file that I brought in because it was much longer, but I still have music in here, right? So I have, what's the duration here? About 30 seconds or something. So that's my clip. But if I use the slip tool on it, watch this, I can shift the music inside of that clip to go, let's say I want to do it for the end of the music, right? So I'm going to shift and go all the way to the end of this file. Look at this. So now the music ends here.
That build busy creating videos or learning.
Yeah, so the music ended. If instead of this segment, I want to have the beginning of the music, you can use the slip tool again and shift that file inside of that segment all the way to the beginning like that. So That's it. On a given length of a clip, whatever is inside of it, you can shift it. And this is good for B-roll. If you have B-roll, like a stock video or something, and you need it for like 2 seconds, but it doesn't really start at the right place, you can just wind it forward to get to the point you want. So that's how that tool works. And then we've got the hand tool, which I already explained. So I hope this makes sense. These are all the tools you have in Descript. Not too many. And they all behave differently. Let me show you how they behave inside of a sequence. This is a problem. And I don't like it. And I wish it was different. But anyway, I have a sequence down here, which means inside of that media file in the script track, there's two tracks. And you see that by the indicator here, it looks like an equal sign. That shows me that that's not just a single file. It has multiple tracks in it. So if I right click in here and say edit sequence, I see those two tracks. You see, I am inside of the sequence. Now, the difference is that if I want to fix crosstalk in here, let's say someone talks over the other person, I will go in my timeline and I will look for a place where I can identify where there is crosstalk, like here, for example. So in these two cases, it seems like Chris is saying something. You can see the purple waveform, and I am also talking over him. So maybe I want to silence this little chunk of audio in here where I am talking over him. Well, you would expect that the range tool is a great choice here because, look, I select it. I make a selection like this. So far, so good. It behaves just like inside of the sequence. But the problem is, if I delete this now, it will not only silence me, but look, my video now is black, right? So I don't want to remove the video, just the audio, okay? I'm going to undo. And what's the solution to that? Well, you could say, well, you just do like before where you make a selection and change the volume. Sadly, the controls of the volume in here now don't apply to a selection in the sequence, only in the composition. This is a big difference in the UI, the way it works, the interface. And look, if I silence this or I lower the volume, you see what happens? I am actually affecting the entire track. So Descript doesn't even care that I made a selection here. So what's the solution here? The solution is to do much more clicks and to make several cuts, several selections to silence the segment. Watch this. I will click anywhere to just remove that selection. Watch this. First of all, I have to go to the blade tool to make a cut before and a cut after the portion I want to silence. You see, now I've got two cuts in there, and this is an isolated segment. Step number two, go back to the select tool. Step number three, select that little segment. Step number four, go and mute it with this button. There you go. It's muted. This is how it works inside of the sequence, a little bit differently from the one in the composition. Now, the other tools kind of work the same. You can use the hand tool to move things around. The select tool allows you to obviously select things. You cannot drag things from one track to another. So if I want to grab this segment and move it around, I can only move it left or right. I cannot move it down like that, up or down. Okay. And the blade tool, it just makes cuts just like usual. And, you know, the range tool, I don't even know what it's here for. If I wanted to silence that and it was an audio only sequence, then yes, I could make selections and delete stuff, right? But if you need to silence with video, that is a problem. There you go. So that's all the tools in Descript. I hope it makes sense.